fucking glacial, if you ask me. So I really appreciate the fact that they have that. That's something that a lot of people were asking for in Dear Esther. And man, did I play that game enough times to be like, fuck. A run button would be super great.
I have lived a great deal among grown-ups. I have seen them intimately, close at hand, and that hasn't much improved my opinion of them.
Hey, you judgy little prick. Everybody's flawed. You just wait one day till you're a fat, ignorant grown-up. Then you'll see how fucking hard it is. Till then, shut your little gob before someone slaps the fucking taste out of your mouth. Sorry, did I come off a little bit aggressive there? Shitty kids. Just fucking hit them harder. Oh, you can't do that. You can't do that. Shut the fuck up. That's why you got so many fucking school shootings and serial killers nowadays. You don't have fucking people beating shitty kids when they're shitty kids. Fucking correcting their misbehavior. Just making excuses for them. Calling them special. Fuck off. Okay, that pathway is opened up, and it is another window that I cannot go past until I retrieve the final book. Oh, so close. So close, but yet so far. And now it's all kind of at the crux of God's feet. Looks like God. Can I go up this stream? No, I cannot. Can I go between the rocks? It appears I can, but I can't get up there. Alright, just taking the wide way around and hoping for the best out of that. Let's bring on the rain. The rain has to be the solution to what... Wow, that had a bit more of an intense change to it than I expected. Holy shit. I still can't do much about that. But let's take another look at that. See how that changes. Oh yeah, that is significant. So I should be able to go up here because this changes just slightly. Okay, it creates a bit of a boulder path. I see. That's cool. I wonder how the... lack of the rain causes that. I suppose the rain caused a bit of a mudslide, thus making a pathway up. Where without it, it would have just stayed solid, would have eroded the dirt and the soil.
We all used to call him the Little Prince. The proof that he lived is that he was charming, that he laughed, and that he was happy. If someone is happy, that is a proof that he exists.
I was thinking, I'm like, if I turn my heart-shaped little box right here, I would fall to my death because all the rocks underneath me wouldn't exist anymore. And that's why they take you away in those instances to prevent the player from fucking up the mechanics of the game and falling through that to your death, or maybe speedrun tactics.
You'll fear no more. You'll see a reflection of him.
Who's your master? And why only a reflection?
Mortals cannot see his splendor and live.
Sounds like some Cthulhu bullshit. But sure.
Is this the countenance of your glory?
That is the skeleton with the Pope hat. Bookseller Honda-san? Oh! Arigato gozaimasu, Bookseller Honda-san. David brought me into his world to have a glimpse of his master. I needed this moment of respite since the path of the exorcism was more than I could bear. I'm back, motherfucker! You're back, motherfucker! Okay, so that's where I got those three hearts already. There should be another doorway, meow. And hopefully I'll get at least four hearts out of this one. And that will be Helena.
Helena. He who calls forth the water of the sea and pours it upon the face of all the earth. Lord of hosts is his name. Satan, the Lord rebukes thee.
Then I take your heart, child. I need it for my ritual. Don't worry, I'm only trying to stop Satan. Images of the children. Mary. Hello, Mary.
God, who is holy, beginningless, frightful, invisible, infinite in power, and
beginningless
in divinity, the King of glory and Lord Almighty, he shall rebuke the devil.
He'll give him a talking to. He's like, devil, what did I say about Thursdays? I know. But devil, we've talked about... Oh, Peter. Stop rebuking me.
Command the evil and impure spirits and demons to depart from the soul and body of your servant and not to remain nor hide in him.
It's like the devil's a moody teenager. God's just like, devil, we've talked about this. Gods. For the love of criminy, can't you just not... Okay, So I got these ones. I'm only missing one. Am I just missing David? Is David at the altar on the other side? Holy Christ, going near the door there real quick. A little disorienting. Has to be. It's the only place left where somebody could be. It's all I can think of. Yeah. Did I miss him earlier, or... No, that's me. That's definitely me. I just wasn't paying attention. So, where's the last one? This is eerie and creepy as fuck, if I may say. Head back to where I began until I hit a bit of a dead end, or no? Well, the last one has to be real damn close. It's just a matter of... Where... Don't get behind me, Satan! Don't manipulate my perspective, because it's incredibly narrow and I'm kind of getting lost real easily and fast. Now, it wouldn't have had me go through that other sequence if I had missed, because the only person I haven't seen is dear sweet Perdix. Yeah, I got you. I got you. Got you, babe. Shit. It's kind of like that seventh doll, except, this might not be as easy to find due to the game being a little bit troublesome. Unless something happened in the environment when I got that last one that kind of changed shit that I just didn't notice. There's that room there. Nothing else in the hallway. I would have swore it would be like right there. But fuck me, right? Maybe must have absolutely missed something in here. So I got you, absolutely. Just close that shit, don't need... Yeah, let's go around. Oh, there we go, there's Perdix. Think, no? Ruth. That's a little annoying. So close, yet easily overlooked. The living and the dead. My God, he's really got the market on that.
I'm fading.
I'm fading. Melting. Exhausted, I fell unconscious on the cold floor. I was dying. Inarticulate, scornful screams were surrounding me, even though I found all the seven hearts.
I'm dead.
Damn.
Do not worry. There's a magic potion that can bring you back.
And one that can change my colors. Oh, David, you're ever so useful. Is this my opportunity to pick up the... Hello? do not play with death. Don't you understand that in this world there are no symbols but only written forms of reality? Stay in the light, play with the light, be the light, and you will survive. Interesting. Hell of a warning. Whatever the fuck that means. Come on, boy. Let's brew this potion. Oh, look at the pretty flower.
Rose. Thank you, little one.
It is the time you have wasted for your rose that makes your rose so important.
There is a really pretty flying ship up there with its anchor hanging. Kind of like a... Okay, it's actually beached, but I'm like... kind of like a Flying Dutchman, in a sense. If it was actually floating there in the sky and not just hanging off the rock face. Now, to the Flying Dutchman
this
I shall go.
This is a strange ship.
Yeah.
It was my home for hundreds of years.
Is there some way of getting in here? It would almost feel that way. But, nah, just admire its beauty from the outside and fucking move along, son. Oh, there we go, it's the puzzle. Zed, balls, and erection. I am a juvenile person. Uh-huh. Balls. And Zed, there we go. The fountain is now running. Oh, it's created a magical bridge for me. How pretty. See, yeah, didn't have to stuff so many of those earlier, religious figures in before. You could have hidden them throughout this area as well, or would have that just ruined the atmosphere? You know, I guess the environments are a bit small for tucking away hidden shit. And then again, it's not like they hid it super well.
David, did you steal this cross?
I'll get my crank on. I don't understand why the game allows you to open drawers when I'm pretty damn sure, out of the whole experience, I've never found anything inside a drawer. Elixir of Life. Light all the candles. Place a cross above all things. Mercy... S-U-L... Sulfur? Ether. A red rose. Have that. Mount Anton's Holy Cross. Mount the cross. Oh my. Maybe I should buy a dinner first. The page from St. John's... Christopher.
Mercury? Why keep it in such a precious container?
And in a baby's cradle? And crib, I suppose? Hello? What do we have? Anywhere... Ooh, hey, that's a...
This must be the page from St. John Chrysostom's book. Let's see what it says.
There we go. Oh, that's not good. Interesting. I just realized that my mouse cursor is being controlled by my controller here. Well, at least it doesn't come up on the screen. I guess that's something that's unavoidable. Can I rotate? No. Wow, this is a big fucking mess. Okay. Like any puzzle, get the edge pieces on the edge. This is... And... Very inaccurate for where I want to grab. There. That's a bit better. Wow, you guys just shredded the whole thing up. Or is that... Okay, that's part of the same thing there. That's not good. Guess it goes on the left. That seems like the right-hand side. Yeah. Oh, they snap together when they... Ah, that works. That I can work with. As long as they, you know, relatively come close to one another. But unfortunately, I've had a couple snap together. That's a bit troublesome. How about that? That lines up. There we go. Clips together pretty good. Now, just need to get these straggler pieces. Why make such a tiny piece? That could fuck a person up. That doesn't seem good. And... no, that's a bit too far off. Still more tiny pieces. Get the fuck out of here with that. Holy shit. So is it meant to indicate two pages with this little crease here? There, now I finally have the option to grab the other side of these letters. Omne Patri, la la. Wow. Okay. Let's work on the central thing here, because it seems to be the best bet. Move you up to the top? Actually, that connects right in here. Click. Excellent. It'd be kind of nice if there was an actual, like, clicking noise. That snaps into that. This hopefully goes into that. Very good. And it's starting to come together now. No odd little stragglers. You seem like you would clip in about here. That looks about right. Excellent. How about that? Perfect. Alright, you get a little bit in, and the thing starts to... It's good that it has a little bit of forgiveness with how easily it clips together. So would that... Yeah, that goes there. And you... That one. Pretty much have this whole side taken care of. Clip. And just the one piece remaining. Whew. That could have been annoying as hell. I have taken you in my arms, and I love you, and I prefer you to my life itself. For the present, life is nothing, and my most ardent dream is to spend it with you in such a way that we may be assured of not being separate in the life reserved for us. I place your love above all things, and nothing would be more bitter or painful to me than to be of a different mind than you. John Chrysanthem. Okay. Cool. Hell of a love letter. So was that up on the wall and it fell down, or did I just not notice it on the floor when I first walked in here? I guess be a little bit more thorough with the looking around of things. Nope. Sure. Now, out here. Nope, that's as far as I can go with that. Can't walk on the rails. Nothing else in the cage. Good, good, good. Jesus. Just every little bit is covered in detail. Sure, not the most highest texture detail, but still fucking impressive, if you ask me. Not that anyone really did, but I'm still kind of taken by it. Alright, let's get this crank. Oh, that was easier than expected. The thing... Nope. Alright, wait. There's something on the other side that must be missing, or there's something in the way that's preventing it from going further over. Is it you? Oh. Ew.
Sulfur, or rather philosophical sulfur, as an alchemist would say.
Well, that's a cool way to indicate that, well, the sulfur that I needed is on the rails, especially since I missed it. Didn't even see it. Had to bang the whole cottage off of it twice before it's just like, motherfucker, there's something in the way. You should investigate that. Now, what's in the way here? Or is it actually in line with the doorway? No, it's in line with the door. Perfect. Yes. Anything hidden under the steps? Apparently, did a little bit of looking when I was sorting out a few little technical issues. And, yeah, I missed two of those signs. One was buried under the coffins behind the children's playhouse. You had to remove a rock from under the wheel of the cart. And the other one was in the cemetery.
What is this sound?
The Romanian monks from the old monastery. It is a call to prayer.
And the other one was in the cemetery, of course, and, you know, I'd seen that woman and her children. I had to approach the woman, and then the child would run away. I'd have to follow the child, and then go back to the woman. She'd disappear and leave a icon of Saint Mary, or Mary Magdalene, I believe it was. Am I just going to drink this random blue ethereal-looking fluid?
My flower. I'm responsible for her. And she's so weak. And so naive, she has four ridiculous thorns to defend her against the world, like you.
Interesting thing. To be, well, described as a thorn of the world. I would never give myself such a lofty title, but I kind of like it. Gives a little bit more significance to my existence, knowing that I'm a thorn of the world. Especially being one of the four thorns of, well, this flower. What is with all the... This is more of like a bassinet, if anything. Oh!
If you love a flower that lives on a star, it is sweet to look at the sky at night. All the stars are abloom with flowers.
That is creepy yet incredibly pretty as well. All the blue flowers with the giant red flower in the middle. Actually, I think they're all pretty much the same size. Or the same rendered object. They just changed the color palette on that one. I have to say, they did not cheap out on the trees. Like, I don't think those are 2D textures. I believe they're fully rendered 3D branches. So they went over the top with quite a few things. The environments, the details in the trees and the foliage and such. But then they kind of... I don't know. Like the character models. I just can't stop because they're horrific nightmare creatures that
Once
shouldn't exist in this world.
Island, one day I found a cave. I walked toward its entrance. Inside, I found the most beautiful toys and the most exquisite sweets.
You shouldn't eat sweets out of a cave. Just saying, it's probably a really bad idea. I watched an immersion episode where it was, you know, eating old food that you find in a cave. In reference to adventure, I think it was.
So this is your hiding place.
Okay.
This is not a game anymore.
So we have to fix Jesus.
Shine within my heart, loving Master, the pure light of your divine knowledge, and open the eyes of my mind, that I'm in you. I see the light of life.
Okay, I think I went through that a little bit too quickly. Jesus had no time. Where is thy soul? Tears of God. Jeez. Tincture. Always with the tincture, eh? Matches. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay. I think this is the position in which I need to be to perform the ritual. Ooh. That is like Archangel Michael and perhaps the devil. Or he's like, we can take heaven from God. Michael's like, guess. Why not? An inferior intelligence does not easily perceive occult and obtuse subjects. Elixir of light, light all the candles, place a cross above all things. So... yeah, that would do it. Thank you, Butterfly. So helpful. Always so helpful. Anything else I can interact with in here? Mercury and sulfur, ether. So, the bowl? I would imagine it's the mercury and sulfur going to the bowl, but... If I can't interact with the bowl, how do I do... Mount Athos Holy Cross. I think that was this one here. I have that. So I lit the candles. Placed the cross above all. The butterfly didn't move, though. So did I fuck up somewhere along the line with that? Or oh, wait. No, here we go. A little bit of that. A little bit of this. A little bit of those. Light. Unlimited candles? Okay, I thought I was clicking on that, but I suppose I was missing. How about we light it up now?
My slave, a child of light.
Yeah, that works. Nice sword. So, pick up this goblet and... Just chug-a-lug-a-lug, hey, buddy? Glug, glug, glug.
I am alive.
Well, we're all. David brought me back to life. He had the power of transfiguring the world, changing sadness into beauty. There's Jesus in the background. He's like, yeah, bitches! Snapping his fingers, such. So, I gathered the seven hearts. I don't imagine... Oh, wait, I... No, I could walk past the one, but the other dude was just too big. Mind you, I'm not in a bathysphere suit, but a diving suit anymore. So, I guess it's time to get the fuck out of here. One second. Can I go? No. Invisible wall. Nothing to pass there. Now, I need to keep my eye out for a ladder. That's the important thing to me right now. And... You know, keep an eye out for shit's locked. It seems as though the volcano has gotten a bit more... Oh. Well, I believe my carriage has arrived, but I'm not quite ready to take it. Not yet. Or I guess I am. Fuck. Yeah, sure. Let's take the carriage pulled by flaming horse skeletons. Don't want to get kicked in the fucking face by one of those. Hey!
Come in, Father. Let's have a talk.
Are you supposed to be a representation of the
Look
devil?
At you, a child of light. We shall destroy you. My master was also a son of light, yet he fell.
David is an angel. Soon, the pain will end.
Don't make me put a cross on your head, man, of my blood again.
Hell preserves the pain. After death, you have no flesh to experience your sinful delights.